This episode of DNews is brought to you by Squarespace. We love the moon because it is close to us. We love the quasi-orbital satellite. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. Seriously, the moon is awesome. It has phases, it makes the tides come and go, plus it's just so freaking pretty. I wouldn't mind another one hanging out in the sky. The more the merrier, right? Wait, what's that you say? We have another moon? Well, not so fast. We actually have a quasi-orbital satellite called 3753 Cruinia, named for the Celtic people in the British Isles. It's not technically a moon, since it's not in orbit around Earth. Just like us, it orbits the sun. It's in orbital resonance with us, which is when two or more bodies get stuck in a gravitational dance with one another. The Earth and Cruinia are about a 1-to-1 ratio, so our orbits are really similar. At times, it looks like we're playing cat and mouse with each other, except Cruinia's path follows what's called a horseshoe orbit. To the sun, it looks like a typical elliptical orbit, but to us on Earth, Cruinia's orbit looks kind of bean-shaped. Wondering why you haven't seen it before? Well, it's small. It's only 5 kilometers wide, while the moon is 3,476 kilometers. Plus, it's kind of far away. It gets closest to Earth at 30 times the distance to the moon, which is a pretty big distance. So Cruinia can't be seen with the naked eye. It takes at least a 12.5-inch telescope to be seen. But Cruinia isn't the only sort of moon we have. A couple other planets like Jupiter have what are called Trojan objects, and in 2010 we found our very own. Trojan objects are natural satellites that share an orbit with a larger body at what are called Lagrangian points. These areas follow 60 degrees ahead or behind the bigger body at a gravitationally stable spot, like an island in space. Our Trojan is named 2010 TK7 and orbits the sun at Earth's L4 Lagrange point. At 300 meters across, it's just a little guy, although still not exactly a moon since it doesn't orbit around the Earth. And then there's 2006 RH120, a miniature teeny tiny moon only a few meters wide. Catalina Sky Survey of Arizona found it in 2006. It seems Earth snagged it out of solar orbit for about 11 months, and by June 2007, it was gone. We miss you, 2006 RH120, but don't get too sad. We have another object, well, a bit of space debris really, orbiting around us right now. B44E is also tiny, at just a few meters across. B44E orbits Earth about 2 to 3 times the distance of the moon. It's really similar to J002E3, which researchers think might be a piece of the Apollo 12 Saturn V rocket. So B44E, it might be something left over from humans going into space. So for now, second moons remain in the realm of science fiction, but they're still pretty fun to think about. We'd like to thank Squarespace for their support of DNews. Squarespace is the easiest way to create a beautiful website, blog, or online store for you and your ideas. Squarespace features an elegant interface, beautiful templates, and incredible 24/7 customer support. Try Squarespace at squarespace.com/DNews and enter offer code DNews at checkout to get 10% off. Squarespace, build it beautiful. All right, guys, how much would you love another moon? Let us know in the comments below. And while you're at it, hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back for new DNews every day of the week.